Hey, first of all, I just love this church. Don't you?
Amen.
I had never heard the laughter thing in this church before.
Amen.
Okay, and I actually believe this. You will know people by the way they live, right? By the way they love, by the way they lead, and by the way they laugh. Amen. And your church is pastored by a guy who, in my opinion, lives really well.
Amen.
He leads exceptionally well. You just saw that, okay? And he loves exceptionally well, and that's pretty rare in pastors. Okay, I mean, you and I aren't even in the game, baby. The cool thing is he laughs well, and that's contagious in a church. Okay, and I wanted to duck in here first of all to say thank you for doing this. There are 75 churches all around America, all doing the same series. Okay, and what happened is this: this book, when I wrote this, it's the only book ever written. It took 7 years to write this book. The reason it took 7 years is, evidently, I am a very slow writer. Because what happened is, if hope doesn't work on the worst day of your life, it doesn't work.
Yeah.
And what I did was, this is the only book on the subject of hope that is not about hope. It is about the seven things that if you will build them into your life, you'll have hope. If you will build them into your kids and teenagers, they will have hope. If you build it into your marriage, they will have hope, okay? And I tell you what, if you don't build these seven things in, you, your kids, your marriage, and nothing has a future without these seven things.
Amen.
Nothing, okay?
Amen.
And I heard this phrase last week, what you plant will grow,
yeah.
Okay? And these are seven things that if I don't plant them into my life, I'm going to be in real trouble. And what I wanted to say to you all is this, I'm thrilled you're doing this. Because there are, matter of fact, this thing hit the Wall Street Journal top 10 bestseller list the week it came out. That's a secular deal, which means unchurched people are reading it, okay? And why I'm excited about that is this. I believe the second somebody gets hope, anything's possible, okay? And if you, and one of the reasons I love this church, okay, is this. If you take a look at what these seven things are, number one, recharge your spiritual batteries. Does that happen in this church every Sunday?
Yeah, amen.
Second, raise your expectations. Does that happen in here? Third, refocus on the future. Is your pastor taking your churches and gotten it off of the past and focused on the future?
Amen.
Yeah, by the way, I'd encourage you for that. Nobody goes forward well when they are looking back, okay? Fourth, play to your strengths. Refuse to go it alone. I mean, I just look at this church, and I got to get back up to the lousy church up the block. But I want to say this, your church, I was thinking about it this morning, and one of the reasons I wanted to duck in here, I want to say this, your church does a better job of modeling those seven things than any church I know of in Northern California, okay? And I want to say it was a privilege to write a book that pretty much tells the seven things that your church is building into people's lives. So God bless you. We love you. What happened to the tent?
The team happened to that tent.
Is that going to be rebuilt sometime?
We've got plans.
Good. When you guys are raising funds, we will help you. We'll take a second offering and add
Amen.
To whatever you guys are
Thank
doing.
Thank you very
okay?
much. Yes, sir.
So, love you guys. Have a good day. God bless.
Thank you.